let's discuss about the word friction for a while. Usually it is quoted as, this word is quoted as necessary evil. Now both of these evil, both of these words are quite in contrast with each other. We actually need it and it is evil to us as well. Why so? See, friction, without friction we won't be able to walk, we won't be able to do anything, we won't even be able to ride, because friction is required everywhere. Moreover, brakes of the vehicle won't work, then all the nuts and bolts which actually holds machinery parts everywhere, they won't work. So there won't be any construction of machinery. So you see, friction is actually required everywhere. But why it is evil then, if it is required everywhere? That is because due to friction, lot of negative thing happens. For example, suppose a car is moving. Car won't move without friction. The tires will keep rotating at one place. The car won't go forward at all. But due to friction, there is a spending of energy, because the fuel is spending more energy. The fuel is being burnt and the energy is being spent to make the vehicle move forward. That is because there is an opposing force acting on the vehicle which was resisting the motion. So to overcome friction, the energy is used. So that is why friction is an evil. Also, the wear and tear of everything. For usually, for example, machine parts, friction works in two ways. First of all, wear and tear of all the machine parts, it gets decayed with the usage of time due to friction only. And also friction produces heat, so heat damages the machinery part. So everywhere friction is doing something negative, but everywhere friction is also important for machinery to work. So that is why friction is stated as necessary evil. Okay, let's discuss few points how we can minimize friction. First of all, the word polishing. We have already discussed about it. Let's do it again. That's a challenge. Okay. So the polishing, how polishing works, we have already discussed the fact that the friction is due to the actual point of contact between two bodies, not the apparent area of contact. So when we polish two materials which are over one another, for example, there is this material and there is this material. Okay, we have these two materials where actual points of contact are these 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Alright. So now if we polish both of the surface, what will happen? The way I have made this diagram, it is very obvious that there are only 5 points of contact. But in actual practice, due to the weight of this body, the point of contacts won't be like this. The points of contact will be increased due to the weight, because there will be a plastic deformation due to the weight of the body, and actually the point of contact will increase manifold. Okay, this is how the normal structures are when the bodies are in contact. So instead of just 5 points, we have n number of points at every junction, right? So what happens when we polish the surface? We do not make it completely smooth, because by making it completely smooth or completely plain, we are actually going to increase the friction. So what actually happens when we polish two surfaces? When we polish two surfaces, these irregularities are removed in a way that the surfaces become this shaped. This is what happens in polishing. So now if you bring these two surfaces, let me complete the diagram. So now if you bring these two surfaces in contact, this part is also spherical in nature, the surface. Similarly, this surface is also spherical in nature at every point at the molecular level. So when two spherical surfaces will meet, there will be only one or two or very less actual point of contact as compared to the previous structure when the bodies were in contact. So that is why polishing decreases the friction. So it actually decreases the actual point of contact due to which the frictional force was arising. Number two, lubrication. Okay, how does lubrication helps? This is another method of reducing friction, that is lubrication. Now how lubrication helps? First of all, the lubricant, it actually fills the irregular gaps between two bodies where there might be a possibility of the body getting stuck with each other, where more points of contact are getting formed. So lubricant first of all fills the gaps and they reduces the actual point of contact. Number two, they also work in a way that I've told you that frictional forces depend on the nature of surfaces in contact. So for example, there is an iron surface moving over another iron surface. Both are completely flat. There is an iron box moving, which is sliding over another iron box. So the surfaces are in contact, are actually similar, iron and iron. So at the points of contact will be many. Moreover, at the point of contact, there will be very easy formation of bond, which is giving a rise to this force of friction. So lubricant actually makes a layer between iron and iron to decrease the adhesive force or cohesive force. To decrease cohesive force, right? Adhesive force is between the molecules of different bodies, cohesive is between the same body. So lubricant makes a layer. So iron is now moving above the layer of the lubricant, and below lubricant there is another layer of iron. So in this way, iron and iron force are not working. Instead, iron and lubricant and iron forces are working. So that is why the frictional force get decreased by many times. Number one, by proper selection of materials. For example, we don't choose plastic tires for our vehicles. We use only rubber tires, though rubber provides more friction than plastic. Plastic has a very less coefficient of friction above the road surfaces as compared to rubber. So why don't we use plastic? Because with plastic, there will be more chances of accidents. Because of less friction, the bodies won't stop once they are in motion. They will stop. Even if they stop, they will cover a lot of distance after the application of brakes, right? So proper selection of materials is always required, keeping in mind that the mu, because the value of mu, which is coefficient of friction, that depends only on the nature of materials in contact. So we use rubber, but which kind of rubber to make tires? Which kind of rubber? We don't use the raw latex for that, because there the frictional mu would be very high. But the processed rubber, the tires are made, processed rubber part, that has a standard value of, or a good value of mu, due to which vehicles will stop in a very good distance. Plus, they also are not open to good wear and tear of tires, right? So the processing of materials is obviously required. So that is all covered under selection of materials. That is the value of mu. Next part is streamlining. This is another method of decreasing the friction. Now streamlining is a concept where there is a fast motion, not just fast motion, any kind of motion. For example, we have a car like this, exactly like this, okay? And now these days we are having cars which are a bit streamlined in shape, right? Like this. So why do we make the surfaces streamlined? To ease the air resistance, because in this flat surface, there will be a lot of air pressure or air resistance which is acting straight away on the windshield. But in such kind of surfaces, the air will be streamlined and the layers will move like this from upper and below the surface of vehicle. So that is why streamlining is very important, especially for high-end cars which are supposed to move at a very high speed. Lastly, by using ball bearings. What are ball bearings? Those small spheres of metal that is usually steel, okay? So ball bearings are used how? Suppose we have to rotate this machine part between or inside this machine part, okay, without any use of ball bearing. So what will happen? There will be lot of friction at these points because the actual point of contact is everywhere, right? So there will be a very huge amount of heat which can actually generate by moving this black part over green part, or by rotating any of them, right? Because number of points are very more. But instead of doing this, because our whole sole purpose is to rotate the black part between the green part, so what we can do, instead of directly applying the machine parts like this, we use ball bearings which work like a secondary machinery part. We use small ball bearings, and now the other surface are in contact with the ball bearings. So this is how ball bearings are used. Now this time when the black one, the central machine part rotates between the outer machine part, what will happen? They are moving with the help of these ball bearings, where the point of contact which causes friction is very less, only 2 per ball bearing, right? With the passage of time, this spheres, this spherical structure of ball bearings, they also get some decompress or some they get out of shape, but still they will have way less frictional force as it was in the previous diagram. So that is why ball bearings are used to decrease the frictional force. So these are the main methods by which you can decrease the value of frictional force.